natural blood thinners, and how to prevent blood clots. Proper blood flow through the body is essential for every organ. The heart needs sufficient blood flow in order to keep beating. The brain needs sufficient blood flow so oxygen can flow through it. But if there is a clot in the bloodstream, it can build up and cause different kinds of issues. Take the aorta artery, for example. It distributes oxygenated blood through the entire body. If this artery becomes clogged, it could be fatal, especially if it bursts. With that said, there are certain types of blood thinners that can be taken to prevent blood clots. And in this video, we'll tell you all about them. Before we get started, be sure to subscribe to our channel and turn on post notifications. This will allow you to receive all the updates from your number one bestie. In most cases, a blood clot is created during an injury to stop excess bleeding from occurring. The body usually dissolves the blood clot once the injury is fully healed. However, if a blood clot forms inside the arteries or veins without a sustained injury, the body may not be able to dissolve it. Because of this, people often experience a stroke. This is why blood thinners are that much more essential. According to the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, more than 130,000 Americans perish each year from a stroke. The CDC also states that every 40 seconds someone in the United States is having a stroke. Each year, there are about 795,000 cases of strokes. And to make matters worse, it's the leading cause of long-term disability. Now, keep watching for more information on blood clots, as well as different types of natural blood thinners. And make sure you stick around until the end to find out how to prevent blood clots. The arterial blood clot. Before we get into the different types of blood thinners, we should discuss blood clots. Let's start with the arterial clot. I've already mentioned that blood clots can develop in arteries. They can block blood and oxygen from reaching certain organs. These types of clots will often form in the hands and the feet. But in more severe cases, they can also develop in the brain, causing a stroke. The venous blood clot. Another type of blood clot is the venous blood clot. This is when these clots form in veins and tend to develop very slowly. Venous clots are more prone to development after trauma or surgery. There are three types of clots that can form in your veins. The first one is the pulmonary embolism. This clot can travel to the lungs and can cause death. The second type of clot is deep vein thrombosis. Usually occurs in the lower pelvis, leg, or thigh. The last type of clot is superficial venous thrombosis. Occurs in veins closest to the skin and can cause severe pain. If you experience inflamed skin, reddened skin near your vein, or a vein that has become too painful to touch, you may be suffering from a venous blood clot. Symptoms of a blood clot. The easiest way to determine if you have a blood clot is to get it checked out. But you need to look out for certain symptoms. If you experience cold hands or feet, loss of color in the affected area, muscle pain, or weakness in a certain area, you should make an appointment with your doctor. The other symptoms of blood clots include heart pain, chest pain, upper body discomfort or pain, and shortness of breath. Blood clots can also make you feel weak, dizzy, and confused. They can also lead to severe abdominal pain, diarrhea, and vomiting. Risk factors. There are certain risk factors that contribute to blood clots. If you have high blood pressure, high cholesterol, suffer from diabetes, or are addicted to smoking, you have an increased risk of developing blood clots. The American Society of Hematology states that the risk factors associated with blood clotting vary between the different types of blood clots. For example, the risk factors for developing venous blood clots differ greatly from those associated with arterial blood clots. Blood clot treatment. There are many different types of treatments associated with blood clots. The treatment that you receive will depend entirely on your health, as well as your location of your blood clot. Some types of treatment for blood clots include anticoagulants, which help prevent blood clots from forming. Thrombolytics are also used to help dissolve blood clots, while a thrombectomy is the surgical removal of a blood clot. Some patients who are diagnosed with venous blood clots may be referred to a hematologist, which is a type of doctor that specializes in blood disease. Now we have finally gotten to the point in the video where we discuss different natural blood thinners. Keep watching to find out more about blood thinners, and make sure you stick around to the end and find out how to prevent blood clots from forming. Vitamin E. Let's start with vitamin E. Vitamin E helps prevent oxidation. Oxidation is when free radicals are produced, which can damage or stress cells in the body and cannot be removed. The best sources of vitamin E are broccoli, kiwi, almonds, and avocados. According to WebMD, vitamin E also has many other amazing health benefits. For example, vitamin E is known for its amazing effect on the immune system. It gives us healthy skin and eyes and protects our cells from damage. Healthline also states that research suggests that vitamin E can also improve our scalp and hair health. This is because vitamin E can help create a protective barrier on the surface of our skin. This helps to lock in moisture. Vitamin E can add shine to our hair by helping reduce breakage, protect our hair from damage, and seal out moisture. It supports the scalp and can give your hair a protective, strong base to grow from. Vitamin E also reduces oxidative stress on our scalps. Omega-3 fatty acids. Another beneficial blood thinner is omega-3 fatty acids. They help decrease blood platelet activity. The best sources for omega-3s are pumpkin seeds, fish, and walnuts. Using natural antibiotics such as onions, garlics, and olive oil can also thin the blood. A study published in PubMed Journal states that natural antibiotics can also prevent thrombosis. Ginkgo. If you have never heard of ginkgo, you might want to include it in your diet. It helps reduce fibrin, which is a protein that is essential for helping blood clots form. When a blood clot is formed, it's because the platelets become clumped. By consuming ginger, bilberry, and turmeric, it reduces the chances of this occurring. Ginkgo is native to China, Korea, and Japan, and can also be used for many different types of disorders like Alzheimer's, according to WebMD. WebMD also states that ginkgo can help with dizziness, mood disturbances, and pain associated with poor blood flow. It contains certain substances which can help kill bacteria and fungi which cause infections in our body. Vitamin C. The last blood thinner that you should consume is vitamin C. It's no secret that vitamin C has massive health benefits. But I bet you didn't know that one of those benefits was maintaining proper vascular health. According to WebMD, vitamin C is one of the safest and most effective types of nutrients out there. In addition to helping with blood clots, vitamin C can protect the body against certain immune system deficiencies, prenatal health problems, cardiovascular disease, and more. Mark Moyad, MD, MPH, of the University of Michigan, states that higher levels of vitamin C in our blood can significantly improve our overall health. Vitamin C is also known to help fight off the common cold and reduce stress. If you'd like to get more vitamin C in your life, there are many different fruits and veggies that you can get it from, including oranges, kiwi, tomato juice, cantaloupe, red pepper, and more. Now that you know more about blood clots and natural blood thinners, here is how to prevent blood clots from forming. The first key to preventing a blood clot is to ensure that you have a healthy diet. As you know, strokes are caused by blood clots that cause a blockage in oxygenated blood flow to the brain. Trying to avoid consuming foods that are GMO, processed, or contain artificial additives and sweeteners is a good start. Living an active lifestyle is another helpful tip. The more active you are, the easier it will be for your blood to flow through your body. If you become lazy, your blood flow can begin to slow down, and you'll be at risk for developing a blood clot. If you're a smoker, you already know that it increases your risk of lung cancer, heart attacks, and strokes. If you do smoke, it is in your best interest to quit. Quitting can help eliminate the risk for many other different types of illnesses, like heart disease and lung cancer. Of course, if you have any questions or concerns about blood clots, it is always best to speak to your doctor first. Do you have any experience with blood clots or blood thinners? Let us know in the comment section below. We want to hear from you. Did you enjoy this video? Hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. And thanks for watching.